Konnichiwa, my tomodachis, it's me, Starlight Senpai, and before we talk about this totally sugoi anime, I need to go on a rant real quick. You mean to tell me a stupid one-off joke from a video has blown up to the point where it is getting animations, fan art, Friday Night Funkin' mods, and even this fucking dweeb made a video explaining it, and he gave credit to an iFunny user? This is getting out of hand. I don't know how this happened. I deserve royalties. I only have like 20 subscribers. No one even knows why the image was made. It was for this video. Dianeko Sugar Girls is a totally sugoi anime by Japanese creator Soap Opera 46. It follows the life of Raku-chan, a totally kawaii neko who loves eating mochi ice cream and hanging with her best pal Koneko-chan. Boy, I love to make her my wife. Along their bokens, they meet a totally sugoi man by the name of Hitoshi-san. Hitoshi-san is an absolute chad who Raku has her Kokoro set on throughout the entire series, but he may be one of the most emotionally complex characters I've seen in fiction. Not only is he just an absolute legend who captures the hearts of Yaoi and Yuri alike, but he's a character who also has gone through immense trauma throughout the series. He has to make lots of difficult choices that are probably going to lead him to lifelong guilt, and it makes me pretty sad. So lay back, relax, eat some Pocky and mochi ice cream, because today we're going to look into the tragedy of Hitoshi-san. In order to get a clear grasp on the character of Hitoshi-san, we need to look back to his introduction. Dianeko Sugar Girls Episode 1. The episode starts off relatively simple. Raku-chan and Koneko-chan are enjoying their mochi ice cream, and after some time they decide to head back home. However, the minute they step outside, Raku-chan notices a man passing by, and she describes him as,
"He's so sugoi desu."
Just as soon as she points him out to Koneko-chan, he directly approaches the ladies and introduces himself. This already gives us something of note about Hitoshi-san. He saw these two kawaii neko girls, directly approached them, and introduced himself right off the bat. This should lead us to believe that Hitoshi-san is a man of confidence, right? Or could it be that this overly confident and laid-back attitude is simply the mask to hide his deeper insecurities? After all, despite not being a neko himself, he still says to them,
"Yeah, rawr."
Could it be he's desperately trying to form a connection to these kawaii nekos by speaking in a similar fashion to them? Despite these possible insecurities, he still manages to, at the end of the day, end up on good terms with them and maybe even have newfound friends. And that leads us on to episode 2. This episode is probably one of the most important events in Hitoshi-san's life. The episode starts off with him waking up and enjoying some Pocky and Ramune, his favorite. That is until he gets kidnapped by some mysterious stranger.
What do you want with me?
Arigatoufly, the girls see him getting taken away in a van, so they head off to save him, which leads us on to the next episode, episode 3. I forgot to hit record! Anyways, episode 3 shows Hitoshi with his kidnapper. His kidnapper explains to Hitoshi that they're gonna have some fun. Probably the homosexual kind. And it's here where Hitoshi shows his pride in his country.
I'm not even supposed to be here. You have no right to hold me captive. There's freedom in this country. This is America. Japan.
How patriotic. But he's quickly saved by the girls before anything weird can go down. And this is where his relationship with the girls strengthens. It shows that he's truly arigatoful to have friends like them, and he says his iconic catchphrase before walking off into the sunset.
Sayonara, kawaii neko girls. Nya. Rawr.
Okay, there's a lot to unpack here. Not only did the kidnapping probably inflict a little bit of trauma, but Watashi also noticed something else. Judging by the tone of voice, the kidnapper, who we'll refer to as Jeff, seemed to have some sexual plans in mind, to say the least. But despite this awful predicament, Hitoshi looked weirdly entranced by Jeff, and maybe even a little bit excited. This is an event we can refer to as Stockholm Syndrome. Stockholm Syndrome is a psychological condition that creates a feeling of trust or affection towards one, typically in a captivity situation like what Hitoshi-san just dealt with. Not only do the circumstances align, but that also goes at hand with what we talked about earlier of him possibly having some insecurities and wanting to be attached to others. Cause keep in mind, at this point he wasn't very close to the kawaii nekos, so it's likely he'd have a feeling of isolation to the point where even a kidnapper brought him comfort. But let's keep going for now, we'll get back to this later. Episode 4 is another significant episode as it gives us our first glimpse into the Stockholm Syndrome truly taking effect. Out on a walk, Koneko-chan runs into Hitoshi-san, and being the sugoi wingman she is, Koneko-chan tries implying to Hitoshi-san that Raku-chan is interested in him, saying he's sugoi, yeah. However, this completely flies over Hitoshi-san's head. Despite having a kawaii neko interested in him, he begins thinking about Jeff, to the point where he completely blanks out on what Koneko-chan is even saying, and Koneko herself even notices and questions if he's okay. However, he reassures her he's fine, and he subtly friendzones Raku-chan by saying,
"Well, I better tell Raku-chan that I think that she's a really cool neko, and that she's pretty, downright sugoi."
And for the next couple of episodes, Hitoshi kinda just thinks about Jeff at random times, and will even sometimes possibly hallucinate him around town. I mean, that could actually be him, it's not really clear, but moving away from the Jeff stuff for a while, let's go into his dynamic with Raku-chan. Throughout the series, it's pretty clear Hitoshi-san doesn't see Raku as more than just a friend, which sucks for her because she also happens to be dying. Yeah, for those of you who haven't seen the series, which you should, you fucking loser, Raku-chan gets bitten by a squirrel. Turns out she actually got rabies from the squirrel, and she's gonna die soon. And once the rabies are done, she has a neko demon inside of her that's also killing her. However, despite Raku-chan's condition, Hitoshi actually remains pretty optimistic and tries to cheer up both Koneko and Raku throughout the series. He'll change the topic, he'll bring them to fun places, give Raku-chan some gifts. Despite all of his inner conflict going on with Jeff throughout this series, he's a pretty sugoi tomodachi throughout the series. However, the final episode really changes everything. Episode 10 of Nya Neko Sugar Girls is easily one of the most gut-wrenching pieces of fiction I've ever experienced, and it beautifully encapsulates the tragedy that is Hitoshi-san's character. To start off, this is the episode where Hitoshi-san and Jeff finally reunite face to face, even if for a brief moment. When they encounter each other at the start of the episode, Jeff leaves behind a letter for Hitoshi-san, and while we don't know exactly what it says, it was likely an invitation to meet up later, judging by the later context of the episode. Meanwhile, the Neko demon inside Raku is back in full force this time. Hitoshi-san and Koneko-chan rush to the vet together, where she performs an awesome exorcism that dispels the Neko demon, but it sadly won't last forever. The vet explains that the spell will only last for one day, meaning Raku-chan probably only has one day left to live. Being the sugoi friends they are, Koneko-chan and Hitoshi-san set out to make Raku-chan's last day on Earth the best it can be. But wait a minute. Remember earlier Jeff told Hitoshi-san to meet up with him that night? Yeah, despite it being her last day on Earth, Hitoshi-san makes the gut-wrenching decision to end that last precious day early in order to chase that eternal love. That's a heavy choice, and it's quite the moral dilemma. Having to throw out a precious last moment with a friend in order to take that one chance you have for eternal love, that's a tough choice for everyone, and it's likely to weigh on Hitoshi-san's mind. I mean, Raku-chan wasn't upset about it. Her day still goes well, she reunites with some old college friends. But I couldn't stop thinking the whole time. She wasn't able to spend the last moments of her last day with the man who lit up her Kokoro. Oh, but wait, no, just kidding. Raku-chan wakes up perfectly fine the next morning. So yeah, that whole last segment was basically for nothing, because I guess the spell worked and now Raku is like free from the demon forever and she's free to live a happy long life. And with this newfound appreciation for life, she now feels the power. The power to finally confess her feelings to Hitoshi-san after all this time. But I think Watashiwa all know how this turns out. He did it. The mad lad actually did it. Hitoshi-san and Jeff officially hooked up. And yeah, that leaves Raku-chan absolutely crushed. And I think this was the moment Hitoshi-san snapped. Seeing Raku so distraught, it breaks him. Him and Koneko, they try their best to reassure her everything's fine. Hitoshi-san even introduces Jeff to them. He tells them Jeff's name is actually Bokutashi-san.
Oh, I thought his name was Jeff.
And Raku tries so hard to convince herself, convince Hitoshi, that it's fine. She's happy for them. They're tomodachis. But she can't ignore the fact her Kokoro is absolutely destroyed. No, she's actually dying of a broken Kokoro. And she's gone. Hitoshi-san is now officially broken. He pushes away Bokutashi-san and runs straight to Raku-chan's side. He's so overrun by guilt in this moment, he can't even look her in the eyes.
Watashi so kimochi that I could spend last day with the two best tomodachis anyone could ever ask for. Sayonara, Koneko-chan and Hitoshi-san.
Raku's dead. And at the end of the day, it was Hitoshi-san's decision that caused that. He tries convincing himself Raku will come back. She'll pull through. But Koneko herself points out, he's just in denial. This guilt? The fact he essentially killed one of his closest friends? That will haunt him. Things are never gonna be the same for him. Raku's gone. Koneko will just serve as a reminder for what he has caused. And Bokutashi is ultimately what led to this situation, and that will leave a strain on their relationship. Hitoshi-san is a tragic character. It can be discussed all day on whether or not it truly was him that killed Raku-chan. But regardless of whether or not this tragedy really was his fault, he'll always feel like it was. And that's shown. It's embodied in this final shot, where all he can muster up is a simple...
Last Christmas, I gave you my heart, but the very next day, you gave it away. This year, to save me from tears, I'll give it to someone special. Yeah. Last Christmas, Watashi gave me my kokoro, but very next Anata give it away. This year, to save me from tears, Watashi will give it to someone special. Once beaten and twice shy, Watashi keep my distance, but Anata still catch my eye. Tell me, baby, do you recognize me now? Well, it's been a year. It was so